Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Anglo American after the global mining company announced plans to cut capital expenditures by $1.8 billion by 2026. Shares of Anglo American tumbled nearly 8%. Also in focus, shares of UBS, which has formally begun the integration of Credit Suisse's parent bank, marking a key next step in the first merger of two global systemically important banks. UBS shares are up 1%. We're also keeping a close watch on Airbus, which has secured an A350 cargo jet deal with Cathay Pacific Airways. Shares of the European aerospace giant are trading higher by 1.5%.
Asian markets ended the week on a mixed note. The Nikkei 225 led decliners as the Japanese yen continued its rally on bets the Bank of Japan's ultra-loose monetary policy may be coming to an end. Dragging sentiment further, a surprise downward revision of Japan's third quarter GDP to 0.7%. That's steeper than the 0.5 contraction first estimated. As for the South Korean KOSPI, it closed 1% higher, boosted by big cap tech stocks. Meanwhile, the Singapore Exchange saw its first listing via an SPAC merger. Taiwanese live streaming platform 17Live began trading Friday after it merged with a special purpose acquisition company listed on the SGX, the Temasek-backed VTAC. In other notable stock movements, shares of Malaysian infrastructure developer YTL surged nearly 10% in Friday trade. That's on reports chip giant Nvidia is in advanced talks with the company on a data center deal.
The Chinese government may be coming out with more stimulus as it vows to spur domestic demand and enhance economic recovery in 2024. To achieve this, the Politburo, the top decision-making body of the ruling Communist Party, said it will continue to implement prudent monetary policy and proactive fiscal policy next year. State media reported during the meeting chaired by President Xi Jinping, officials also pledged to prevent and diffuse risks to cushion an ailing recovery in the world's second largest economy. In recent months, the Chinese government has launched a slew of policy measures to shore up a feeble post-pandemic economic recovery impacted by a property crisis, local government debt risks, slow global growth, and geopolitical tensions. Rice prices in the Philippines expected to increase before the next harvest season. Rice industry stakeholders warn gaps in local supply and increasing prices in the international market may drive prices up ahead of March. According to the Agriculture Department's monitoring of rice prices in Metro Manila, local well-milled rice ranges from 45 to 57 pesos per kilo, while imported rice is at 52 pesos per kilo as of December 7.
Abot ng up to around 30 pesos per kilo. Ang equivalent po niyan sa presyo po ng bigas sa retail, mga roughly mga times 2 yan. Tapos yung imported na bigas na pumupuno po sa ating kulang sa supply, eh mahal po at saka nagmamahal pa rin. Plus may parating na El Nino, so baka magka-problema po tayo ng konti sa supply.